Hello everyone, welcome along to another Ski Sunday, number 16 in the series, which began at the start of the year. I hope you're all well, having a nice day. It's lovely and sunny here in London. Planning to go to the park after this if I can. It's a little bit cold, but still very nice. So yeah, what am I going to be doing today? So this is a track which I absolutely love. It's called Together, and by Thomas Bangalter and DJ Falcon. It came out on Thomas Bangalter's label, Roulet. Year 2000. So really kind of the height of the French house scene, French touch, whatever you want to call it. It was a massive scene. It was great for me because I was signed at that time to Columbia, France. So I was going out to Paris quite a lot and doing shows and promotion stuff. So it was a great time, just a brilliant time, I think, for dance music. Very exciting. Why did I choose this track? Well, a number of things, really. First of all, I saw a tweet from a colleague of mine, Frank McQueenie, he just reminded me of the track and how great it was. And we shared the love for it. And then another thing as well was I just stumbled across this video, which was posted quite recently, actually. It's basically a recording of the Daft Punk Alive tour, and it's been restored. I'm just looking at it down here. They've done a really great job. And I was just like kind of going through that and just reminding myself how amazing that Alive tour was and how influential it was. And then at the end, there's this kind of amazing mashup where they do Human After All, Together, and One More Time, all together, you know, like together. And it's just when the track Together comes in, it's just epic. So I thought, I'm going to dive into this track and just see how it's made up, really. So as ever, I've done kind of not that much preparation. I'm putting myself in at the deep end here by trying to kind of put it together. So it may not be seamless. I'm going to be trying a few things out. But as ever, a brilliant resource for these kind of things is whosampled.com. It's a great website. And what it's got here is it lists the samples that are used in this track. On the actual record, I'm pretty sure it only credits like one sample, which is basically, it says contains sample from Because of You by Keith Nash. It's Nash, isn't it? Not Nosh, Nash. So that's a band called Slave. So that's credited here. But then there's also a vocal sample from this track, Sincerely Yours by Sweet Sensation. Interestingly, both from 1988. With the Slave track, and it's actually the a cappella they use for that, so I'm presuming that the a cappella was made available on the B-side or something. And then there's also a sample at the start of the track, which is from a film. It's just an introduction sort of vocal monologue, and that's from the film Pleasantville. And then finally there's the bass line, which is interpolated, which means it's kind of played again, and that's from the Beverly Hills 90210 theme. So I've got all the tracks in Ableton Project, plus I also recorded this as well, this version. I wanted to kind of make sure that I got it kind of straight from vinyl, and just to kind of see what the tempo, you know, get the exact tempo. Sometimes you kind of get these things off YouTube or whatever, and they may have been pitched up, so I wanted to get the right version. So as ever, just feel free to get involved in the chat if you have a question, or you want to give me any suggestions or whatever. Just let me know. Just want to say also before I start, a big shout out to Tom Middleton, who sent me a message this week and gave me some great tips. And I know that he's a big fan of this sound. Spent a long time working on French kick drums, apparently, according to the message. But yeah, Tom, if you're watching this, thank you so much, and great to have had you involved in this. So cool, let's go back over to Ableton then. Here we go. So this is what I recorded in earlier today. I won't play through the whole track.
Decision. Are we in this thing alone, or are we in it together?
So there's the Pleasantville. So that's the Sweet Sensation loop. And then we have the slave loop coming in. So it's a great kind of, already it's really interesting because it's a great kind of question and answer. So that kind of goes on. And then we get the beat slamming in. So just very quickly, just to show you what I've done here, I'm going to bring up my keyboard. So, in fact, let's just hide it for a second. So I recorded it in, and I've warped it, but not to kind of manipulate the warp markers in any way. I wanted to kind of keep it exactly as it is. But what I have done is I've used the repitch warp, which means that I can basically kind of, as I speed up the tempo, it will also affect the pitch. So it's exactly like just using the pitch control on a record player on a turntable. And the reason I've done that is because the original version is a bit out of tune straight from here. So I think they may have kind of pitched the whole track down, or they may have, when they took the samples, they may have had the pitch down. I'm not exactly sure, but I think to make it much easier for me to put samples in, you know, the right pitch so they're working together and also play along, I wanted to make sure that it was actually a kind of concert pitch, so it's going to make it easier. So if I just bring this back here. So what I worked it out as is that it's in B flat minor. And when the bass line comes in, it goes. So if I just play along. So I'm playing these chords here. That's like a B flat minor over D flat. And that's an E flat minor, A flat, and then B flat. So we'll get into that a bit later. But basically that's, you know, for me kind of getting it in time. So it is actually in time with the tempo. So let me just, there we go. And we're running at 127.5. So it's a little bit faster. Now it's in Ableton, it's a little bit faster than it was from the record, but that's just basically, as I explained, just to get it in time. Just gonna have a quick look at the chat. Hey, Yes Music On, how you doing? Great to have you along. And everyone else that's joined. Cool, all right, well, let's get into it. I'm going to start off by looking at the first sample, which is this one, Sweet Sensation. It's the a cappella version, as I said. So let me just drag that in. There we go. And I'm going to put this over here. There we go. Now it's automatically warped. So I'm going to take that warping off for the moment. And the first thing I want to do is just try to actually locate where that sample is. So let's just open this up a little bit and just have a listen through. Take the metronome off.
Write you this letter to show you how much your love means to me. I wish we could be together. I need to win my life, oh, can't you see? You promised we would be together, but you still have.
There we go. We got it already. Amazing. Right, so I'm going to chop that out.
Be together, but you...
When I first just had a look at this, I didn't realise straight away it was the a cappella version. It was So I was thinking, God, how do they get rid of the beat and the music? And then I was like, ah, yes, there's an a cappella version. In fact, you know what? I should really credit, just give a shout out to this YouTube video. So let me just see if I've got this. Did I make a note of it? Here we go. Yeah. So this is great, and I think someone pointed this out to me as well. This was a really, really good starting point. So this is a video that's been up for quite a while.
It's not about Roy's shirt.
It was put up in 2010, and that's great because it basically helps me, alongside looking at who sampled. So anyway, cool. So I'm going to get rid of that now, and we've just got this loop.
Be together, be together.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this as a reference, the original as a reference, and I'm going to, just so I can kind of just be as faithful as possible, and I'm going to just try to sort of line it up, and I'm obviously trying to sort of envisage exactly what they did here. So let's just pull that over there at the start of the track. And, you know, we can actually kind of look at the waveforms as well. So let's just...
Be together.
Okay, so obviously that's kind of wrong at the moment. The first thing we need to do is to get it at the right pitch. So if I just mute that for a second.
Together, together, together.
All right, so let's just help ourselves by playing this in. All right, so it's going E flat, F, together. Okay. Whereas this.
Be together.
Okay, so that's kind of like an F, G. Sorry, I just got rid of the keyboard, didn't I? Let's bring it back. Okay, so what we can do is bring it down two semitones. So one, two. So let's just do that now. And we can just do that even though we haven't warped it. Well, the fact we haven't warped it as well, you can see that it's kind of changing the length. So if it was warped, it would just keep it as the same length, but it's not. So let's play it now.
Be together, be together. Be together.
Okay. So the next thing to do is to make sure we've got the right start point. So if we listen to the original again, it's pretty rough how they've done it, how they've looped it.
Together, together.
You can even hear the like little kind of glitch there, which is all part of the charm, to be honest. So now I'll just quickly show you this picture, which I managed to find, which is this. And this is them in the studio. And it looks to me like they've got an Akai S950. And they've got a similar keyboard here. They've got the old version of the Roland, I think it's the PC200, which I used to have and finally died on me last year. But anyway, so let's just see if we can match up the start point here. I'm going to make this a little bit bigger. So let's just get a kind of ballpark. So So there's no kind of t of the two. So let's just go here.
Be together, be together, together, together.
Okay, so now we can actually see a bit clearly, a bit more clearly here, how the waveforms are matching up. So I can actually do that, bring it along.
Together.
So let's just cut that now.
Together.
And actually, before I kind of copy it over, let's just play the two together now.
Together, together, together.
That's pretty cool. So it may even be that I can adjust this so that it's actually kind of almost like phasing.
Together, together, together.
Let's just loop it now and make it easier, won't it? And let's just see if we can line it up even more accurately.
Together, together.
I think that's pretty good, to be honest. Let's just take the original out now. Okay. All right, I'm happy with that. Although, actually, that's not looping properly. Here we go. Okay, good. So I'm just going to manually loop this. I think I'm going to start off just working in a range view and then see if I can pull it over to session view later on so we can actually kind of play it in live. So we'll see how we get on. All right, so that's that one done and dusted. Now let's have a look at this one. So let's take that out. Right. So this is Slave. So let's load this in now and see if we can find the elements of this track that we can use. So again, I'm going to take warping off. So interesting, we've got the beat there at the start. It may be that we can use that. Hey Moda, by the way, sorry I missed you there.
I've got this everlasting love for you.
Right, let's see if we can find it.
When you've got that glow, I love. Maybe it's just for me. Nobody will ever take us apart. Because of you, life is so real together.
Hey Demi. Oh, right, yeah. Auto add fades to clips. Yeah, that's a good point, actually. Let's just see where that is. First person that can tell me where that is. Anyway, it's probably going to be here, isn't it? Auto, here we go. Create fades on clip edges. Off. There we go. Just hope it doesn't crash Ableton Live now. All right, so let's keep looking at this, see if we can find it.
Nobody will ever take us apart because of you. Together.
There we go.
Life is so real. Together.
We got it. Amazing.
Life is so real.
All right, let's just chop that bit out. Nice. All right. So I'm going to copy that and we're going to put this over here. There we go. And let's see if we can get this in time now. So what I'm thinking is that they may have started off with that first loop, the Sweet Sensation, and then tried to kind of get this in time. So let's see if we can get it in time without warping it or without any kind of what they would have had time stretch at that time within the Akai. I'm pretty sure that the S950 had time stretch. But let's just see what it's doing first. So let's just play this now. All right, so interestingly, so it doesn't come in on the 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. So it comes in on the 3. And that's how it creates that kind of question and answer. So the first bit of it is. All right, so let's find that kick and see if we can get this in time. There we go. So it's there.
Together.
All right. So let's do another thing where we can actually figure out the notes that it's in the original. playing D flat and E flat together. All right, so that's that. Sorry about my singing. And I just hid the wrong thing then. Okay, if we go back to here, what's this playing? So it's like, it sounds to me like it's C D. So we need it to go up. Initially, I think we need that to go up a semitone. So let's put it up a semitone. And you can see, because I like the other sample, because I haven't got it warped, it's changing the timing of it. Still sounds a bit out. Let's try tuning it down a bit, maybe. That's more like it. So I'm just tuning it down by cents. That's minus 45 cents. So now if I just play it now with the metronome. All right, so we're going to have to warp it, basically, because that's... It's now at the right key, but it's not in time. So they must have time stretched it, I'm imagining. So we can use warp for that. Right, so let's just drag that over. And let's loop that as well. Maybe let's get the right loop. There we go. And let's just loop this as well. All right, there's a bit of kind of flamming going on there, so I think we can probably improve that loop. Didn't actually put in a transient marker, so I'm putting my own one in. Okay, so let's see if they play together now. There we go. Cool. So let's just see if that now. Yeah. Okay. So that's good. So let's just duplicate that over a few times. And let's just, we haven't got the original in. So that's my version. So that is working pretty well. I'm just going to see if I can take this reset fades. Yeah, okay. So let's just reset the fades as if we had that setting, eh, Demi? There we go. So we've got the fades off now, hopefully. Is it that one in? Okay, that's interesting. So but it didn't seem to do it. Maybe I have to do it a few times. There we go. I thought it would just do it all in one go, but never mind. We don't want the fades. There we go. All right. And just for speed, let's just delete that and then just duplicate that over. There we go. All right. So I'm just going to quickly refer back to this now, the original, and just see if there's anything that they're doing with this sample. So it sounds like it's with that slave loop, they're kind of cutting it at the end. So there. And then later on, they're letting it play all the way to the end. So at what point do they... There. Cool. So in that case, let's just do the same thing. Let's just copy that over. I'm just going to colour that actually, just to give myself the reference. So okay, so that's doing the right thing, and then here, so actually, yeah, what it's doing is it's just extending that out. Oops. Okay, so that's interesting. So if I now take that loop off, and then. There we go. I'm feeling now this could be quite difficult to do in session view. There we go. Cool. All right, so just playing that now. We got a... All right, so let's just now. All right, so that's now. I'm kind of just chop that up in a slightly different way. I'm gonna color that, and it may be quite a good idea to actually consolidate that as well into a separate loop. All right, for the moment, I'll leave it as it is. And then just... Right, now... I'm going to see if we need to use any of the drums from that track as well, because you remember there were some drums at the start of it. If I just get rid of this now. Maybe that's just the drums from there. All right, let's look at maybe a bit of EQ to try to give it a kind of similar sound. And also maybe kind of add some redux to it as well to make it sound more like the 12-bit S950. So let's just... Let's try the redux. So let's put that down to 12 bits. Also taking the sample rate down a bit. And also what we could do is just add the auto filter, because I can hear that later on in the track they're actually kind of taking the filtering down, so they're actually kind of cutting off that bottom end. So I'm quite glad that I haven't consolidated this yet, because I think that it sounds to me like still it's cutting off a little bit too quickly on that bass line. So let's just bring it over a little bit more, maybe just a tiny bit. There you go, let's see what that sounds like. Difficult one. Maybe it was kind of, it was like two samples and it was kind of hanging over. Let's listen to that now. Okay, I've got another solution to this, where I'm going to duplicate that track down there, and rather than just having that coming straight afterwards, I'm going to actually bring that over like that, and then that over there, and then maybe we can, at that point we can fade it down, how come the create fade's gone now? Is that something I have to put on back here? I'm getting all confused now. There we go. That's weird. Okay, that's kind of achieving it, the result I wanted, a bit better now. Just. Okay. Maybe in that case we can even have this going on a little bit longer. Cool. All right then. So I don't think we do need to use the drums. I think the drums in there are fine as they are. One thing I will do is I'm using this, I'll now kind of group these maybe, and then I can just use that auto filter and the redux. There we go. Great, so let's now drag that over the group. Cool, so that's on there, and then I can, to be honest, actually, I can probably use that EQ as well on the group. There we go. But let's just put it in before then. There we go. And then I can take that off. And that off. There we go. There we go. That's even better, isn't it? Nice. Well, that was a bit drawn out, but I think it's worth it because trying to be as authentic as possible. All right. And I suppose it would make sense to use a similar effect, the Redux and the Redux, maybe even the EQ as well. So let's just put that on the Sweet Sensation loop. Right, so let's look now to see what other elements we can put in. Let's just put those there like that. So we've also got this Beverly Hills 90210. Now, I think I said before this was like an interpolation, so I don't think it's a sample. But let's have a listen to it anyway. There we go. Let's drag it down there. Cool. Might be nice just to sort of put it in anyway, and maybe we can even kind of EQ it. Well, that's interesting. Because if I just bring up my keyboards, so that is the actual notes. All right, so let's see if we can get that in time for a laugh. Let's just copy this all over, all the way down for when the beat comes in, and this as well. Right, so it comes in here. We haven't done the beat yet, but we'll get to that, definitely. Right, so it's coming in there. What do I do with that? It's over there. Oops. Copy. Let's bring it over here. Right, let's see if we can get this in time. So there's no, we haven't even got the luxury of it starting on the one here, which is a shame. So we're going to have to do something to this. Let's just have this starting at the one, set 1.11 there, and then let's just count. I think it just comes on the two. So it's one, two. Oops. One, two. So it's actually there, isn't it? All right, so it's too fast at the moment. There we go, rock out. All right, so let's just sorry, Demi, I'm using the fades, but I'll get rid of them where I don't need them. All right, let's just play that with the track now. Whoa. done a rock version of the track. Amazing. All right. Now, I'm pretty sure that they actually just interpolated it, but what we could do is we could just kind of EQ it. So, so it kind of takes off. It just does actually sound like a bass line. Sound like it's lagging a little bit. Let's just tighten it up a little bit. All right. Well, look, we'll leave that there for the moment. And I think next we should concentrate on drums. Okay. Let me just name this. I think at this point I should probably do a save as well and have a little bit of water. Right, so let's try a beat. Actually, I'm just wondering at this point if I should just start switching over to session view, because then that will just make things a bit easier, won't it? Yeah, let's do that. All right, so this is in time, the Sweet Sensation. So that should be simple enough just to copy over. There we go. I think what I'm going to have to do though is I'm going to have to warp that. Which is not exactly what I want. Together. Yeah, that's annoying, isn't it? Okay. In that case, let's do it a different way. Let's just loop that and then just use the consolidate time to new scene. That might actually be the easiest way of doing this anyway. So let's play that now. Look at that, that's brilliant, isn't it? So that's done the, that's not only put that in time, but it's also cool. And in that case, we can go over to where I put the new version of it in, which is there. And let's see what it does for that. That's going to be interesting, isn't it? Wicked. Consolidate time to new scene. Gotta love it. In that case, let's do this as well then. Let's do the Beverly Hills 90210. Let's loop that and do consolidate time to new scene. Cool. Great, so now let me just check now to see if I go on here. and go to the auto filter. Let's look at a beat. So for this, I have got a loop that I was using. I actually did it on, I did a deconstruction of Stardust Music Sounds Better With You. And there's a beat from that that I thought I could use here. So maybe that with a sort of combination of that and a kick. So this is, let's just take this off now because I don't need that on there. I can put that monitor to in. Right, so I'm going to turn everything down. So we've actually got, we can actually get this beat coming through. A bit too much, let's turn it back up again. So that's the beat, it's just a loop. So let's put that in. Ties on, yep. Alright, so that's quite good as it is, and I quite like the kick, but I don't know if it's going to be enough. So I think what we can do is get a 909 as well, and maybe we can just take off the all the kind of bottom end from that beat and just rely on the 909, which I don't know exactly what they did, may well be what they did. So yeah, let's use the 909 core kit. There we go. And there we go. And just, I think to start with, I'll just put the EQ8 on that. There we go. Let's record that in. So maybe we can actually put a bit more of the original bottom end in there. There's some other sounds in this beat. There's another snare. There's a hi-hat as well. Let me put that in. All right, so let's try and slam this a bit. As anyone may know, if they've looked into any of the kind of production side of Daft Punk, this was their favorite compressor, the Alesis 3630. I think I had one of these at one point and got rid of it. You can still pick them up actually, pretty cheap. So it's a pretty crappy compressor, but that's what they used, and that was again part of their charm. I think that and everything going through a Mackie 1202 desk as well. So yeah, let's group these drums. And maybe just a bit of processing on these. So let's start off with the classic drum bus. Too bad. I think we can do a bit of EQing as well. Maybe just bring out the snare. Also, I think I might just bring down that, hi-hat a little bit. Okay, so it's just kind of nestling in the background there, just driving it a little bit. Okay, and maybe just over the top of all of that, we could put some more compression. So maybe we could try the distressor. Just to kind of slam it a little bit more. So it's just... Maybe we can just take the mix down a bit. That's with it, without it. Oh, actually, is that on? Did I put that on? Oh, I just put that on that loop, didn't I? I didn't put it on the actual. Hey, thanks for the subscription. Much appreciated. I should have put that on the group, and I know why I need to do, and that's I need to just do a bit of housekeeping and just call that drum sub. There we go. Okay. Pretty happy with that. I think that's pretty cool. I think now let's do the interpolation part where we put in the bass line and those chords. I've got a couple of sounds that I have in the arsenal. So this is the classic. I use this on everything. Chicago type bass. Great. So let's just see. Yeah, I've got this in mono. That's cool. Let's just bring the keyboard back up so you can see what I'm playing. And let's just check that I'm playing that in the right place. Okay, let's play it in. Great, now I might have to do a bit of work on the feel of it. Maybe just with the length of the notes. Yeah, they're not kind of staccato. Just fold that. There we go. Bring those out. And also, I think there's a bit too much release on that bass sound. Cool, and there's one other sound which is, I think they must have played in, which are the kind of chord sounds which I was playing earlier on the electric piano. So let's get something in from that. So yeah, this is another one that I sort of tinkered around with. I used the Tal Uno LX. Just love it. There we go. Whoa, sorry, that's really loud, isn't it? We didn't need that. Yeah, let's just bring it down a bit. Let's bring the keyboard back. There we go. So I'm kind of deliberating over these because there's a number of ways. It's very hard to hear in the original what it's playing. It could be like, or even, I think it's that. So let's put that in anyway, and see how it sounds in the track. There we go, so it was the second time round. I think that was right. Just bring it down a bit. I think I might take off some of the bottom end. It's a bit, sounds like it should be a little bit kind of thinner. Okay, so what have we got here? We've now got three scenes. Together. quite a nice kind of texture underneath. I wonder if I can maybe gate that a little bit. That's more like it. Cool. I think that's pretty much. Oh, I know what we need now. We need the Pleasantville at the start. Let's get that. Okay. And maybe we can even play a clip from the track as from the actual film as well, because I think I've got that in here. There we go. Bring that down there. Cool. So hopefully you can see that. So let's just forward it to where we think that's going to be.
Are you all right?
Here we go.
I came home like I always do. And I went in the front door. And I took off my coat. And I put down my briefcase. And I said, honey, I'm home. Only there was no one there. It made me one of those.
Okay.
You're with us now. What are we gonna do, Jess? This isn't some little virus that'll... Thanks. He asked her what she was doing. She said nothing. She was just thinking. My friends, this isn't about George's dinner. It's not about Roy's shirt. It's a question of values. It's a question of whether we want to hold on to those values that made this place great. So, a time has come to make a decision. Are we in this thing alone, or are we in it together?
There we go.
Time has come to make a decision.
Beautiful.
A time has come. A time has come to make a decision. Come to make a decision. Are we in this thing alone, or are we in it together?
Cool. There's a bit of music underneath that, so just a tiny little bit. So yeah, let's put that over here.
A time has come to make a decision. Are we in this thing alone? Or are we in it together? A time has come to make a decision. Are we in this thing alone? Or are we in it together? A time has come to make a decision. Are we in this thing alone? Or are we in it together?
Do is have that so that we can actually play it.
A time has come to make a decision. Are we in this thing alone, or are we in it together?
That's nearly there, isn't it?
So, a time has come to make a decision. Are we in this thing alone? Are we in it together?
We'll just leave it like that for the moment, I think. All right, cool. So, I think we've got all the elements now.
So.
Actually, no, we haven't, because we need to have a version of this on its own.
So,
let's bring that up there. Okay. There we go. Cool. So let's just have a little very quick play through this. And yeah, thank you everyone for checking in for this. This has been really good fun. I love kind of getting involved in, researching the samples and seeing how it was all put together. So yeah, let's just let's give this a play from the start. Here we go. Together.
So a time has come to make a decision. Are we in this thing alone? Or are we in it together?
Great. Thanks, everyone. I'll be back next week. Maybe even doing something during the week. I'm not sure yet. But thanks, everyone, for listening, getting involved, and enjoy the rest of your Sunday. Thanks a lot, everyone.